Welcome to the third tutorial in this series of sorting algorithms. Today's algorithm is insertion sort. Like selection and bubble sort, it helps to visualize a sorted and unsorted section. But this time, the sorted section doesn't start out empty. The first item in the list is labeled as sorted, which is valid because a one-item list will always be sorted. Insertion sort works by taking each unsorted element and inserting it into its correct position within the sorted section. In this example, we'll store the card to insert here at the bottom. The first unsorted card is 4, so that's where we'll start. Now focus your attention on the sorted section. To find out if this is the correct insertion spot, we compare the card to insert with the adjacent card. 4 is less than 7, so this is not the right place. 7 is shifted to the right by 1, filling the open slot and opening up a new one. There's nothing else to compare to, so this is where we insert 4. Next up is 9. 9 is greater than 7, so we have already found the location of our next insertion. 6 becomes the next card to insert. 6 is less than 9 and 7, but not less than 4, which means we insert 6 between 4 and 7. This leaves us with just one unsorted card remaining. 2 is less than every card in the sorted section, so one by one, they're all shifted to the right, resulting in an empty slot at the very front. After insertion, all cards have been sorted. Now let's learn how to implement this functionality using C++ and a different set of cards. Here we have an array of 5 cards. As stated before, the first element is labeled as sorted. Here's the accompanying code. Card to insert is represented by a variable named val, because it refers to the value we want to insert. Slot minus 1 refers to the element preceding the open slot, the one we compare against. We kick things off by stepping into the first pass. N minus 1 passes will be made rather than n passes because the first element is already sorted, meaning it doesn't require a pass. 9 is the first unsorted element, so this is where we need to create an opening. Open slot is set to the value of pass, which is 1, the position of card 9. 9 is stored in value, and then we enter the while loop for comparisons. This loop will continue to execute while two conditions remain true. 1, there are still more sorted elements to compare against, and 2, value is less than the element located at slot minus 1. 9 is not less than 3, so we break out of the loop immediately and insert 9 back in the slot. Now we enter the second pass and 9 becomes part of the sorted section. Because this is pass number 2, open slot is set to index 2. And value is set to the element at that position, in this case 8. 8 is less than 9, so we move 9 to the open slot and set the new open slot to index 1. You could actually combine these two statements into one, like this, but for clarity I chose to keep them separate. This time 8 is greater than slot minus 1, so we break out of the loop and insert 8. Next is pass number 3. Open slot is set to index 3, value is set to the 3 of clubs, and we start comparing again. 3 is less than 9, so 9 is shifted to the right. 3 is less than 8, so 8 is also shifted to the right. 3 is not less than 3, so the 3 of clubs is inserted here. With only one unsorted element left, it's time for the fourth and final pass. Open slot is set to index 4, and value is set to the 4 of clubs. Entering the while loop, we find that 4 is less than 9, and less than 8, but not less than 3. So the 4 is inserted at index 2. The cards are now sorted. That concludes this tutorial on the functionality of the insertion sort algorithm. If you would like to see the analysis of this algorithm, click on the following link or check the description. Also, if you found this tutorial helpful, let me know by liking the video, commenting, or subscribing. Until next time, thanks for watching.